Is Dubai really expensive? Hi, and welcome to my second vlog about Dubai. I've been in Dubai for exactly 2 years now, and I thought of sharing my experience about the living costs in Dubai, especially when it comes to accommodation. What you will get from this video is information about the requirement on how to rent a place in Dubai, and how the cost changes according to specific factors. Let's get right into it. As you probably know by now, I try to make the vlog as informative as possible. So I have structured the vlog into three main parts. And the first part is accommodation. In this first part, I will break down the consideration behind getting your desired accommodation in Dubai. So stick around if you want to know how much an ordinary person working and living in Dubai spends on accommodation. Finding an accommodation in Dubai is very easy. Apart from the social media platforms, there are several websites such as Dubizzle, Beyoot, Property Finder, where you can find endless listings of properties. And sometimes you will find on the building advertisement notice as well. Or just Google rent a place in Dubai and you will be struck with loads of options. Now that you know where to look for your accommodation, there are two key factors that determines how much you will spend on accommodation in Dubai. First factor is you need to decide what type of accommodation you're looking for. Accommodation in Dubai comes in different settings. Do you want to live in a shared accommodation, a bed space, which is rather popular in Dubai, or do you want to live alone? All these three types of accommodation comes with its pros and cons, but that is left to you to decide which one best suits you and your budget. Let's look at the first option, which is living either in a room or a bed space in a shared apartment. You will have to share the facilities with other tenants, which is usually around 3 to 7 people. This includes sharing the kitchen, the laundry machine, the living room, and sometimes the washroom. And this type of accommodation is typically furnished. Renting a room or a bed space is usually done without a formal contract, a handshake deal as you may say, where you pay the rent typically by cash, but bank transfer can also be arranged. Your utilities, such as water, electricity, and internet, are typically included in the monthly rent. Security deposit may be required depending on the agreement with your landlord, but usually it is a fraction of your monthly rent, ranging from 300 to 1500 dirhams. The next option is living alone, which means renting either a studio or a one-bedroom apartment, which usually comes in as furnished or unfurnished. Or you can even rent a hotel room. If you want your private space, you most probably need to enter into a lease contract and connect with a landlord, a developer, or a real estate agent. You may be asked to provide documents such as your Emirates ID, your passport, or even your working visa here in the UAE. This is so that they can apply for your tenancy contract, or EJARI as it is called here in Dubai. Keep in mind to check with your agent if you would be required to apply for your own utilities and internet connection, as this would need another set of requirements and security deposit payment. Important thing to note here is that you have to pay the rent by post-dated checks. What it means is the payment will be broken down into 6, 4, 2 or 1 check on a yearly basis. So keep in mind that you may require to have a fund to pay at least 2 times of your monthly rent before entering into such a contract. In general, the security deposit for a studio or a one-bedroom apartment is 1 time your monthly rent. And also note that you may have to pay commission to the real estate agent. Now that you know about the details behind securing your accommodation in Dubai, let's look at the second factor in determining how much you will pay for your accommodation. We already discussed about the first one, which is what kind of accommodation you're looking for. And now for the second one, as you probably have guessed, it's the location where you want to stay. As you are most probably aware, Dubai is renowned for its luxury living in certain locations. So the location is a key factor in budgeting for your accommodation. I will try to break down how the cost of accommodation varies in Dubai based on the location. On this map, I group the location into 2 groups, Group 1 and Group 2. Group 1 consists of commonly affordable areas, with rent starting from 800 to 1500 dirhams for bed space, 2000 to 3500 dirhams for a room, and between 3000 to 5000 dirhams for a studio or a one-bedroom apartment. Group 2 is mostly where you have premium accommodations. Usually these areas are very westernized, starting between 1500 to 2000 for a bed space, 2500 to 4000 dirhams for a room, between 3500 to 7000 dirhams for a one-bedroom apartment or a studio, and it could go more depending on how luxurious you want to go. Now let's summarize what we have discussed about and put it in a table to see the final cost of your accommodation in Dubai. So in this table, I have accommodation type against the group 1 and group 2 location which I discussed earlier. And I have listed down the prices for each type of location and type of accommodation as well. At this point, the next step is to arrange for a viewing. The viewing process can be arranged on the same day, and moving in can also be arranged immediately depending on the availability of the space. So there you have it. The two key determining factors for the cost of your accommodation in Dubai are what kind of accommodation you're looking for and the location of your accommodation. If you have any further questions or are just curious about accommodation in Dubai, don't be shy to let me know in the comments below. If you have got some value from this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe for future valuable content. Until then, catch you in the next one.